Here we're given the vapor pressure of chloroform at two temperatures, and we want to determine from the vapor pressures the heat of vaporization of chloroform, which we're going to assume is independent of the temperature. And so what we're going to use is the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, which relates the vapor pressure at two temperatures to the heat of vaporization, the minus sign, the ideal gas constant, and then 1 over the temperature 2 minus 1 over temperature 1, where temperature 2 corresponds to vapor pressure 2, and temperature 1 corresponds to vapor pressure 1. First thing we got to remember, these have to be absolute temperatures. So 24.1 C, we're going to add 273.2 to get temperature in Kelvin, and minus 6.3, well, it's going to add 273.2. So I'll substitute in the log of pressure 2 is 53.1 kilopascals, and pressure 1 is 13.3. So we can take the log because the pressure units cancel. I'm going to end up solving first for delta H of vaporization over R. So we substitute in this temperature T2 that corresponds to pressure T2, and then temperature T1. So first we'll do the math. And I carried out the calculations to more significant figures on the calculator. And so I can solve for heat of vaporization over R. And then I can solve for the heat of vaporization. I'm going to use R of 8.314. joules per mole per Kelvin. So note, this term has units of inverse temperature. We multiply by joules per mole per Kelvin. We brought that term to the other side. So right now, this has units of Kelvin. We do the multiplication, 30,043. joules per mole, which makes it 30.0 kilojoules per mole. And we only keep three significant figures based on the three significant figures in the original problem statement.